Yeah, hi guys. So today I'll be showing you how to upgrade RAM and how to clean your fans in Asus laptops. So Asus laptops have this problem of collecting dust a lot in the fans, and that's why the fan doesn't work. In my case, this fan actually does not work a lot. The speed at which it runs is quite slow, so I decided to open it up. I didn't quite find a lot of videos, so that's why I decided I would make my own video. So let's get right to it. By the way, I do not have the budget nor the production standards of Apple or MKBHD, so please bear with me with my video quality. So first of all, you will have to remove this screws. These screws I've arranged in the same order as this. So there are four screws at the bottom. You'll have four small screws over here, and then there are three screws over here. These six screws are the auto ones, and this is a small screw in the middle. So remove all of them, and after you remove it'll this back panel will be still attached to this. So for that I used some kind of metal sheet. You can always do it with a credit card or a debit card also. So what you gotta do is you just have to place it over here and just wedge it slightly slowly so that you get some kind of a sound. And after that, keep doing this throughout the back panel and all sides, but don't put it inside a lot. I mean, just the outer periphery is fine. After you do that, you can just remove this back panel. And yeah, so now we'll first look at cleaning the fans. So for fans, so you'll find these two other fans over here, and you will have dust and other stuff over here also. I mean, all over the area. So yeah, I just used a normal paintbrush to just remove it out. As you can see, I've already dusted most of the parts. So let's go with the fans first. So for the fans, you will have to actually remove all these. So I'll just quickly remove these screws. So this is one. For this fan, it's just two of them over here. Okay, so yeah, you can see I've removed these. Then focus here. So you can see that there are two panels over here. So remove the smaller one. So we remove this slowly. Yeah, and this is the power supply for the fan. So we slowly remove this out. Yes, and yeah, do not remove this one. Not remove this one. So after removing this, carefully just remove this wire out of the way. So for this wire, yeah, also guys, it's better to drain out the battery. I did it beforehand. It suggested that it's better to drain out the battery before you open the back cover. So yeah, so now you can see that this is slightly loose over here, but the part of the fan actually ends here. So this is it's still under this heat sink. So for that, you gotta lift the heat sink a little and slide the yeah, just a minute. Yeah, you gotta slide it out slowly and carefully. Yeah, you can see the fan is out. Now, for removing this panel for the fan, you'll actually have to. There'll be some small black things over here. You can see here, 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 here. So in my first try, I had actually removed those. It just comes out as a small clipping. So you just have to use this metal sheet again and just pluck it out. So as you can see, I've already done it. So this comes out like this, and you can see the fan here. So be careful with the fans. Be careful with the fans. I didn't try to remove the fan itself because I thought I wasn't sure if I could fix it back. So I just remove the panel and you can clean it out. So after you clean it out, just put the fan back in its place like this. Yeah, so you can see that it's fit quite snugly. Okay, so I'll just put the screws back. Yeah, make sure it's tight. Also, you make sure that this power supply cable goes into this smoke plug in the right way. So in my case, the red was on the right hand side, so just make sure it goes in properly. Yeah, make sure it's tight. Moving on, even this is the same thing. Even this one, but then this one you have three screws. It's actually much easier to remove and work with because of this tape over here. So it holds these panels properly and you can clean it out. So it's much more easy. I won't go through it because it's nearly the same procedure. So in terms of RAM, so I have this Adata 8GB DDR4 RAM. It's a single channel RAM and I think it's frequency is around 2666 megahertz. So for the RAM, just remove it off and just place it in this RAM slot over here. So just be careful that you buy the right sort of RAM. I bought this from Amazon. Make sure that your laptop is actually compatible with it. I read on the internet that I already have an 8GB RAM, and I read that if you install a 16GB RAM, it won't be as efficient. So I just bought an 8GB RAM, and it was quite cheap also. So for the RAM installation, there are some pins over here. So if you look in, wait, let me just point out the pins. There are pins over here in this region. I hope you can see that. So after you just have to align this RAM properly. And before that, let me just explain some things. Can you see these two pins? These two pins are very important for your RAM installation. So what you got to do is, the RAM installation is pretty simple. What you got to do is just put your pins up front. Okay, it just slots in. Now you gotta make sure those pins align with these two small holes. Okay, as soon as it is aligned, just click it in and it slots perfectly. That's it. So you can put that back. Then you can you have the battery pack over here. This is the HDD. Then you have the CPU over here. I assume that's the CPU or one of them, the graphics processor or the GPU will be over here. And yeah, this is the other panel you have. I think this is the SDD, and these are the speakers, your jacks, Ethernet cable, Kensington locks over here. Yeah, that's it. If you want to work on this in some other areas, I mean, even in the HDD, I think you can just remove the HDD also. There are some screws at the sides, so you remove that and you can replace your SDD. Yeah, so I'll just put this back, and then we can see that your RAM will be upgraded to 16GB. So yeah, that's it for this video. I just hope I've cleared off address the issues some people are facing with this particular laptop, because I was facing this and I had a rough time figuring out the solutions, I mean the ways to remove dust from the fans. And I thought I would just make a video on it to make it easier for the others as well. Yeah, so that's it for you guys. Yeah, stay home, stay safe.